All right, guys, what's up? Welcome back to more of PGA Tour 2K21. Today, we're taking a break from the career mode. Yesterday, I did that kind of easiest settings video, which was fun, but I still uploaded a career mode video yesterday. Today, we're going to be doing the society event. So it seems as if we found a workaround for the difficulty restrictions. So Frankie Borelli from Barstool Sports actually DM'd me and helped me out with that. So shout out to him. He's an awesome dude. And he helped me and Crazy Canuck as well. He has a YouTube channel. He creates courses and stuff like that. So shout out to the two of them. They kind of gave me this workaround that we can do where basically we go into the difficulty restrictions and just back out straight away or something like that. Not sure exactly how it works. My mod Darren set it up, but yeah, I don't think it's too difficult to actually do. Anyway, we have the society running on Xbox, PS4, and PC. I'm playing on PS4, obviously. And if you want to play on any of them, just search up the Apex Hound with no spaces and you should be able to find it. So I'm going to show you guys my difficulty settings because I've seen already in the social section a lot of people are complaining about the putting, but it's something you're probably going to have to get used to, all right? So swing difficulty is pro, swing timing is on. See, if I could turn this to like putting percentage only, or putting only and percentage only, I probably would, but I don't want to have it open so that it can be on completely. Distance control assist is off, putt previews off, course yardage on. All of the pro visions are off, including true shot, including pro trajectory as well. Scout camera set to UI off. Lie grid, green grid are on. Pin preference is out. It's whatever, though. It doesn't matter, really. And then wind speed and carry are on as well, and the aim marker is on. So there you go. That's what you got to do. Those are the settings you need to play. If you want to practice on them, go ahead and practice on them before joining the society. That's fine too. And we have over 1,000 members in the society already, which is truly incredible. But as you can see here, guys, putting impossible. Putting was very frustrating. Putting not beginner friendly in the slightest. So people are having trouble with the putting. But as you can see, we have over 1,100 members now, which is really cool. And we're gonna jump in and check out the first real event, because the first one didn't count because everyone was just cheating and using the easy settings. The BMW Championship starts now. Let's go, baby. So I am using this Ben Hogan driver. It doesn't really go as far, but it has more forgiveness, and I don't know if it's worth it because I'm still missing fairways with the Ben Hogan driver, but I'm not hitting it as far, you know? I am hitting more fairways, I would say, but I don't know. I might go for this white one. It has slightly more forgiveness than the gold one, but goes a little bit further as well, you know? And the white one still carries 287 or something. This is the one Tyler was using and he said was pretty good, but I think that's pretty similar to the white one that I have. So I think I'm just gonna go with the white one for now. We'll stick with this for now and we'll try and just try and hack our way around. Let's go, baby. These are my clubs, if anyone was wondering. I have the Wilson 3-wood. The Wilson D7 3-wood. I have a Bridgestone hybrid. No, sorry, Callaway Maverick hybrid. TaylorMade Sim irons, and then I have the Bridgestone wedges and the Ben Hogan putter. So there are my clubs if anyone was interested. Let's jump into the first round of the society event. I'm not sure if we'll do two in the one video. We'll probably just do the one. We'll see how it goes. All right, let's go. Also, gonna crack open a monster, and don't even talk to me because I was up to like 2 a.m. talking to a lady of the night. All right, and I woke up at like 7:30, so got me some slack here. Respect to all the people that are worried about my health, but I'm fine. Trust me, I don't drink them that much. Like, people probably think I drink so many monsters. I literally only drink them when I'm recording videos. And only when I'm recording like certain videos that are, I kind of want a little boost for in the morning. I don't like record them. I don't drink one with every goddamn video that I record. I drink them like,
hello there, my name is John.
Not every day, I would say, but every second day, something like that, when I'm doing a video.
Riviera Country Club, lucky us.
Ooh, I don't know. Is this getting too far?
Let's crank this into the fairway.
I feel like it might be. Set a couple practice swings just because. Yeah, that was pretty good. Decent. Decent swing, at least. That's pretty good as well. Okay, one of them was slightly fast, one of them was slightly slow, so this one's going to be right down the middle, baby. There you go. Perfect. Just don't be too far. It is too far. I put a lot of stop on it, though, so it should actually be okay. Watch. Yeah, it's going to be fine. Beautiful. That's about as good as it gets there. here at Riviera. So we're playing the BMW Championship at Riviera. I don't think they had the actual course. Oh, shit. I don't have a club for this. Dude, I meant to do that. Fuck! I meant to switch. This would literally be the perfect club for it as well. I meant to actually switch out so that I have a 3-iron instead of a 4-iron. Because the 5-iron and the 4-iron are really close together. They're like 8 yards apart, so I don't even need the 4-iron, really. I could do much better with a 3-iron, because look, it would be so much closer here. It would probably be like, what, 195 or something? 192, something like that, so it would be much better. Here, like, we're kind of screwed. All right, I'm going to try... I don't know about this, but I'm going to try and hit a big cut with a lot of loft and a lot of stop, and hopefully... Upon hopefully. No. See, it makes it so much harder to hit, and I did not feel like that was a red fast shot at all. Like, at all. I hit that pretty decently, I would say. But, like, when you put a lot of loft and a lot of spin, it makes it so much harder to hit. Alright. We can still get up and down from there for the birdie. I probably should have just hit the 4-iron. Never gonna hit a pitch there. Don't ever even try and get me to hit a pitch there, buddy. Well, are we on a downslope? No, we're on an upslope. Okay. Okay, I'm going to do the 23, but I'm going to put some D-loft, and I'm going to put some of that. I'm going to aim a little right, and boom. Oh, I hit it red fast, but that's okay. That's going to be okay. Not brilliant. We have a slim chance for the birdie. After such a great drive, it's disappointing, honestly. It would be really disappointing if we didn't make birdie. It breaks a lot, like, right where I am, but then it stops breaking as much down along the way.
Well, that putt'll end up short.
Jesus, what was that?
Here we go. This one for par. Looking pretty
good.
What
was that putt? Oh my goodness. Let's have a look at the leaderboard. Is it going to show us?
And after that one, even par.
No? Oh, there we go. Okay, Jordy's 4-under through 10, and that's leading the tournament. Okay.
Okay, careful out there. All right,
I can respect it. I want to do well in the society event, like, maybe top 20? No, top 10, maybe, because people are still getting used to the settings and stuff, and I've been playing the game for a while. Hooked. Really? Red fast. I don't know why I'm consistently surprised when it goes in the red fast, but, like, it's always in the red fast when I don't feel like it is. Don't feel like I've hit it there, you know? Alright, so, 14 yards... This should be pretty good, I would say. This club right here should be pretty decent. A little bit fast. Might be okay still. Really good. Really good from where we were. We'll take that all day. That's going to get a little better as well. It's coming back towards the right a bit. That's a great shot. Out of the rough from where we were. Give ourselves another good birdie chance here on the second. This time we better not pussy out of it though.
12 foot putt here.
Get in.
A good one.
Yes, sir.
Nice.
Yes, sir.
For birdie.
Let's go. There's a good birdie. Really good birdie out of the rough as well.
Right, that hole will bring you down to 1 under par.
1 under par, baby. All right, Jimmy Hima. 2 under through 10. We got an American up there. We got a Canadian up there. We got a golf club guy up there. Don't know where that location is, but he just lives in the golf club. He never leaves. Right, okay. Got a pretty wide fairway here, I'll say. Was that still fast? Wow. 87% power. I'm trying to get it to, like, so I don't hit overswing. But it's really hard to actually do that when you have the distance control assist turned off. There you go. That was really good. You kind of got to just stop it a little bit sooner, I feel like. I was still fast, but that's good. Because I pushed it as well, so... It wasn't very fast or anything, so... We'll take that. 300. Well, 300 plus. We'll take that. And,
And second shot here on the third.
Give ourselves a good birdie chance again. That'd be nice. It's 8 foot down, but that's not too crazy. Ooh, it does kind of push to the... I'm going to aim, like, just left of the flag then. Because it's an orange kind of... But the 6-mile-an-hour wind should cancel it out, probably. I'll put a tiny bit of D D-loft and a tiny bit of topspin on it, and hopefully this will bounce on nicely onto the green. That's a perfect golf shot. Be the right distance today, sir. Okay, yeah.
We have the right club here.
Okay, the wind definitely affected it more than the lie. And it was too far as well. Okay. I hit it good, though.
So, that's all right, though.
Can't be too mad. I'm pretty happy with how I hit it.
Third shot's looking like.
That's what our third shot's looking like. Go in. Oh! We hit it the exact right power. Just a little fast.
And but we'll save your par.
We'll settle for the par, and we'll move on to the fifth. Eh?
On this one.
All right, one under, two, three.
One, you'll stay right there at one.
Not bad.
Par.
I love the tennis courts there. I've actually played Riviera a couple of times, so I know this course.
And
Cooks McCooks is up there on the leaderboard. We played him on stream the other night. If you missed that on stream, we played him on stream for a shirt, and I bottled it. To be honest, well, we ended up tying, but I really should have won the match. But we ended up tying on the last hole. He missed the putt to win it. Okay, so that should be really good, man. Oh, really? I actually think I need to do a swing recalibration again, but because I'm swinging it a little bit differently with the analog now than I was before, and I'm kind of getting
for the bird
a little bit more inconsistent, I would say, with the tempo than I was before, but. We'll see. So 28 inches up. That's a lot. Jesus Christ. Okay, so that would make it like 53. We would want near 30 inches up when I'm aiming up here, actually. So we'd literally need to be aiming near 83, wouldn't we? Would we? Like, that seems extreme. I'm gonna set. Okay, we'll try that. Oh my, I thought that was going in, man. I really did. I thought that was going in. All right.
Exactly hard.
All right, a solid start. One under through four.
One under for the
no bogeys. We're playing well. But we can do better. Let's go low.
Left to right on this one.
With how good I've been playing in my career mode, I'm feeling good. Feeling positive. It's a 432. It's 43 foot down, so I think like the driver could be too much here. Yeah, I don't think it's even worth hitting the driver there. I'll hit the 3-wood. Red fast. Come on, wind. Come on, wind. Come on, wind. Should be okay. No, it got the terrible bounce. Stuck with a heavy. No, come on.
That green.
Really?
Right now, you might need to club down here.
I know it was kind of facing that way, but I thought it might bounce straight at least for us. It's not a terrible lie is the only thing here, but I don't know if we can reach with the wind the way it is. Because if I go hybrid, the lie's worse. All right. It's definitely going down that way a little bit. I'm going to aim right. I'm going to hit a draw. I'm going to put some D-loft on it. And hopefully upon hopefully, this will be just about enough. I'm going to aim actually up here even. Because the... Yeah, the lie's pretty terrible there. Go on. Get up there, baby. Get up there, baby! What a golf shot! I'm playing some good shots out of the rough. It's saving us, because I'm not hitting fairways. I need to start hitting more fairways, man. Maybe I need to switch back to the Bridgestone driver.
Down to two under.
So I feel like it's better to be a little bit back in the fairway, but out of the rough in this game, it's not unplayable, you know? Like, it was in the golf club sometimes. The heavy rough's just unplayable, which is more realistic, because the pros can hit it out of the rough. And the good thing is it depends on the course. Like, certain courses, the rough is a lot more difficult, which I like. No, I should have left it where it was. I didn't hit it anyway. That was a ridiculously difficult
right,
putt
nice
for a birdie.
Two-foot putt.
But another tap-in par, my friends. We need to start making some birdies if we want to make a move at the leaders.
All right.
But as it stands,
right there at one
we are in a tie for... we're solo fourth. Oh, it doesn't say... No, the other guy's one under two, but it says he's fifth. Weird. Does it not have ties on the leaderboard?
On this hole.
In the society? Maybe not. All right, 9 mile an hour winds, but I literally can't hit this club. So I got to hit this club with some... good amount of D-loft and some topspin, and hopefully this will be enough. A little bit of a draw, get it to just kind of kick on to the front of the green if we can. I hit it slow though. That was the one thing I didn't want to do there, was hit it slow. If I'd hit it fast, like, it would have probably been okay, but hitting it slow there is just not good enough. If I'd hit it fast, probably would have just been middle of the green, you know?
Okay.
Whereas slow is always going to be short. Where's the splash? There we go. Okay, I'm going to hit the 23-yard splash, and it should be pretty decent, I would say. There you go. Great shot. All right, should be another par.
This putt's about 4 feet.
Another boring old par, my friends.
This putt's going.
Jesus, I nearly like, that'll smashed that through the break there. That would have been awful. Okay, four straight pars. We got three par fours in a row to finish the front nine. Let's try finish the front nine at least like two under. That'd be nice. Oh, that would be tied for the lead as well at the moment. Jordy messed up a little bit. Wasn't he four under? He must have had a double.
This one's clocked.
Unlucky, mate.
Par four.
Unlucky, lads. 10 under. A little bit of a fade, maybe. Get it around these trees. And this is a pretty shortish hole, so should be okay. What?
Hopefully this sticks to the...
Dude, every time I feel like it's so smooth, it's red fast! Like, it's boggling my mind, man. We're like, if I hit it deep, if I hit it like a... If I feel like I hit it fast, it's in the black fast. If I feel like I hit it smooth, it's in the red fast. It's weird. It's really weird. And it's bugging me. Jesus, man. I can't believe that. Like, legitimately can't believe it. 15% would be like 15 yards past, which would make it like 140. I'm gonna need to go to the 150. Problem with this is that it's like below our feet. It's gonna shoot right. Especially out of the bunker. Okay, everything's red fast now. What's going on? I'm confused.
Right, we are back in the fairway.
It's either red fast or slow. Like, where's the in-between, boys?
Stroke off the lead.
Oh, just needed a tiny bit more.
Shot there, pure.
We just hit three red fast shots in a row. Even the chip was red fast. Like, what's going on here, boys? All right, it's another par. I'm not going to stop focusing on that shit.
And that'll keep you at one under for the round.
Start focusing on what we can control.
That wind is blowing right.
Which is making a few birdies. I'll go to the left side. Why would I not, right? Well, I guess it's a little bit riskier. No, I think left side's actually easier to even go for, even with the driver. Okay, I'm just going to try a couple of practice swings here, just to get back in the rhythm. Like, I don't get how that's fast. I really don't. Maybe I'm bringing the club back too fast, because a lot of people are saying about the rhythm of the club is like, it's all about bringing it back the same tempo as you're going forward. So maybe I'm just bringing it back a little too fast as well. Because there, both of them were perfect and slow. But I brought it back a little slower. There, I brought it back fast, yeah. So maybe, yeah, it does have a lot to do with bringing it back. Because, yeah, I pushed it fast through there, but I brought it back slow. There you go. I was red slow. Really? Okay, so now I'm kind of hitting them all reds. Like, what? Really? There we go. Okay. All right, let's try that. There you go. Okay.
Tee shot's looking nice.
It's just all about learning, man, because I'm still learning how to play this game as we go. I'm learning the rhythm of the putt still. I'm learning a lot. Like, I'm getting better every day at this game, and that's what I love about it, is it's such a challenge. There's so much, of a skill gap between the top and the bottom. Like, there's so much room for improvement all the time, just like real golf. Like, you can always improve yourself, and that's one of the things that so far I really love about this game. Okay, this should be pretty decent, I would say. There you go, another perfect one, baby. Be good.
Heading for the green.
Be good. Sit. God, it got a big kick on, didn't it?
Yeah,
okay, I did put a tiny bit of D-loft on it, so it makes sense, but...
You could go to 2 under with this putt right here.
2 under? Let's do it then, baby. Let's go to 2 under, finally! I played that hole perfectly, man. I deserve that birdie. Let's go. 2 under. If we can get our rhythm right, that's the kind of stuff we'll be doing. No bogeys. Solid golf so far. Two under par. We're one shot off. Cooks McGooks. I'm coming for you, Cooks. I'm coming for you. He's leading the way at three under par.
Let's see what we can do on the ninth.
Okay. Let's see what we can do on the ninth. 11 mile an hour winds. Let's go. Also, I uploaded a Mafia video if anyone's interested. I know a lot of you guys are just here for the golf stuff. That's fine, but I uploaded a Mafia Definitive Edition, the remake. I got a preview build of that, so if anyone's interested in checking that out, I'd highly appreciate it if you did. And drop a like on that video as well. It would mean a lot to me. Because I like doing other stuff just other than golf, you know. I like mixing my content up a little bit. That was really good. It's a tiny bit slow, but that's
nice. Should be
that's not
going to
affect it at all. When it's like that much either side, fast or slow, it really doesn't affect it. Maybe on like a close wedge shot or something, but with the drives and kind of long irons, it really won't make a difference too much.
Elevated green on this one.
Okay, 10 mile an hour winds with us, but there's it's 22 foot up. I feel like the wind is going to affect this a lot more than the elevation here. And the fact that we're kind of on the ball's above our feet slightly as well. Yeah, let's go. Let's go with this. I'm just going to hit this straight up. I don't think I needed to do anything with it. Maybe put a tiny bit of stop on it. Help out a little bit. And that's a perfect shot. Be right. Go. 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 Oh, it did need to go a little bit more, actually. But that's a good shot. That's a good shot. Below the hole. Putting uphill.
Good job.
And a good chance for back-to-back birdies here. Ooh. A little bit of a double breaker here, huh? Definitely breaks a little... does it? I'm thinking it breaks a little bit more to the left, but, like, not by much. It didn't. It was dead straight. It was dead straight. No, I pushed it. I just saw my swing plane, actually. I pushed the shit out of that putt. Okay. It would have probably been in the middle if I didn't push it. Damn it! That's annoying. I do that with some of the putts, actually, at the top. At the top of the swing plane, it just kind of swerves off to the right. But that's a solid front nine, 33, out in 33, and we'll see what we can do in the back nine. Let's go! Cooks McGooks, we're coming for you. He's through 12 holes, so he's got a couple holes on us. All right, guys. I feel like I can go for this with the driver that I have. So the wind is going to affect it a little bit, of course, but I feel like I can get in that front bunker or on the front of the green. That was fast, yeah. Okay. But I feel like I can definitely... That was perfect. That was so good. That felt so good as well. That was pretty good. A little bit slow. It's going to be front bunker. Why did that go so far right, though? That was only a tiny bit slow. Like, it was only 9 mile an hour wind, man. Like, the wind affects it so much more in this game than it did in the golf club, I swear. And this is going to be a difficult shot, man. It's on a downslope. I don't even think the chip's going to get up there. That's the thing that I'm worried about. Like, I legit don't think the chip is going to get up there. It won't have enough height. I might have to try hit a splash here. Like, a partial splash. Like a 50% splash, though, like, legitimately. Like, back to... Like, I legit needed, like, a 12-yarder. Like, even less, maybe, like... That's as far as you can come back, actually. Holy shit. 60%, okay. Let me try see what a 60% splash is like. Is that it? That was 50%, but that was very fast as well. Holy shit. Okay, so it needs to be, like, there. 67%. That was even too much. Wow. And it's fast. Like, it's hard to get those partial shots not fast. That was okay. That was just black fast, but still. It's impossible not to hit it fast here, I swear. Like, what? Okay, wait. Let me try that again. There you go. Okay, I hit that one slow. You gotta really go slow through it with the splashes here. That was still very fast. Damn it! God, that was such a difficult shot, though. I should have probably tried the chip, but I was worried that it literally wouldn't get up. We kind of got fucked on this one, man. I did it to myself, probably, but I don't know. I feel like we got a little bit shafted. A little bit unlucky on this one, man. Get in. Get in! No! Oh, that would have made up for it. That was cruel. That was such a good chip. I thought it was just going to go in, man. Damn it.
Just tapping that one in for par. Nice.
All right, we're still bogey free. If I can go bogey free, I'd be super happy with that.
Two under for the moment.
Two under. We're one shot off the lead. Like, we have to remember these settings. Like, people are still getting used to them. It's tough. It's really tough. Like, it legitimately is tough. Yeah, I'm bringing it back too fast. 100%. There you go. Oh, I thought I was taking a practice swing. I legitimately thought I was taking a practice swing. It's fine, though, luckily. Good thing I was, like, doing a full swing, because otherwise we would have been in trouble.
Second shot here on
it's
the
a par 5 here. We can't get there. No, we can't get there. Even if I... Ooh, we have a really good lie with the driver, though. Like, a really good lie with the driver. Why is our lie with the driver so good? That's kind of strange, honestly. But it's so hard not to hit driver off the deck fast. Let's try once more. That was slow. Yep. I was going to say, just as I said that, I knew I was going to hit it slow.
Taking driver.
That was red fast then. Of course it was. But it's going to be okay. It's going to be on the green. That's a hell of a shot. It's good. Come back around. All right, we're chipping. It might be better to hit a splash here from this distance. I feel like
our third shot.
I don't know, actually.
Ever so close. One stroke off the lead.
I'm going to hit the gap. It's downhill, but then it goes uphill is the thing that worries me. Oh, I hit slow. No! It's okay.
Here we go.
It's not too bad.
30.
Oh, it is. It's a tough 7-footer now, actually.
Good.
Let's go! I hit that too hard, but I just got away with it. I was like, from that view, it's different, but we just got away with it. 3-under. Let's go. We're tied for the lead now, right?
Down to 3-under after that one.
No, Cooks! You did it to me, Cooks! Damn you, Cooks! All right.
Bit of a long par 4 here.
It's okay.
Nothing you can't handle, I'm sure. So,
nothing I can't handle,
put
brother.
It in the fairway.
You know that. Let's do that.
A little awkward on that swing.
What? Wind. No, that's too far. I genuinely struggle to believe that was red. Like, I how?
From the long grass here. Let's get on out of this.
Oh, damn it. We don't have a shot. We literally can't get on into. Yikes, man. Let me down in that creek. I think I'm just going to lay up to a good distance. If I hit this 62%, it's probably gonna it's gonna get nowhere near 50%. No, it's not even worth it. I'm just gonna hit this. Hit a big draw. Get up!
Well,
I should have probably just laid up on the fairway there. It would have been the smart play. Because we don't have a good lie here. This was a terrible idea. I shouldn't have done that at all. Terrible idea. What was I thinking, man? It's not a bad shot at all from where we were.
Okay. Four.
I shouldn't have been there, but if we can get away with the par here. No PBFU. Come on. I didn't fucking hit it again! No, dude! If I had hit that, it might have got there. Like, legitimately, what is that? I've done that twice now. Where it's a 30%er and I hit a 27%. It pussied out of it completely. That's a PBFU. First of the day. Damn it. Our first bogey of the day comes right after a good birdie. That's so depressing.
Par 4 here. Let's have a nice clean.
That was such an avoidable bogey, too. Like, I literally just made a brain-dead decision to hit the second shot and try and get it across to the other bit of the fairway.
Found your hook.
Dude, what is going on? What is going on with this red fast shit? I'm continuously hitting it red fast now.
Here.
Off the tee. Like, and I feel like it's smooth.
Alright, here's our second shot on the 13th.
I definitely need a swing recalibration, dude. Holy shit, that's getting annoying. Really annoying, in fact. Good shot. Go. Go. Chase. Chase! Stop. I said chase and it just kept chasing. Alright. That's a good shot, though.
Okay, on the green.
Here's if we could have a bounce back birdie, punch. That'd be real nice. Right in the middle. Right in the middle, baby. Let's go! Bounce back birdie.
Fourth birdie of the day.
Shooter McGavin, let's go. Bogey birdie, or birdie bogey birdie.
And 3 under par for the day.
If I can finish 5 under, Cooks McGooks is 5 under through 16. Careful, I imagine he probably finishes 5 or 6 under, hole. I would assume. 8 mile an hour winds. Do I want to draw it into the wind a little bit? I don't even know if I want to hit this club. I probably do with a little bit of loft. The wind's going to affect it more then, but okay. Let's go with that. Oh, that's so good, dude. Be the right distance. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. Sit, 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 sit. That's about as good as I could do, honestly. I landed that at the very front of the green. Oh my god, it's still going. I put loft on that, too. Like, that was just a tough shot, because the pin position was kind of just beyond the bunker was always going to be difficult. Okay. Doesn't really break as much at the end, though, does it? Yeah, it didn't, but that's pretty damn good. Tap in par.
Okay, tap this one on in.
You're right. We played that hole really well.
Here.
But.
All right, that's gonna.
It was just a tough tee shot. Oh, he's 6 under now through 17. Okay, Cooks. He's going off.
Let's see what happens here on this par 4.
I don't want that rematch anymore, Cooks.
Fairway, take it from there.
Me and him, like, we were talking about a rematch because we tied. To finally get the shirt or whatever. Okay, like, I'm hitting a practice one here to make sure I don't hit a red fast off the bat. There you go. Yeah, like, that was smooth as hell. Okay, perfect.
Drive's looking good.
Perfecto, my friend. It's par 4? Are the rest of them... Is there any more par 5s, or... I don't think there is. Dude, what are you doing? How does that still keep going?
Could have sworn that was
Jesus, man.
Down.
No. Living yeah, so could I, but we got shafted. Simple as, mate. All right, this should be perfect the way it is. Just the way it is. Yeah, the wind affects it a little bit, and it kind of does fade that way as well, so the green kind of fades away to the right, so it should be perfect. A little bit fast, but that's going to be fine.
Let's go kick right, kick right.
That's going to be really good. Sit down, sit down, sit down. Oh, big bounce with the 9-iron? That's a big bounce to get with a 9-iron, man. That was a... These greens and these fairways are rock solid. You really got to play for the bounces a lot. Like, that's so unfortunate, I feel like. Right? I'm going to hit a splash here. Am I? I don't know. I just hit that 90% power and it still went 19 yards. With loft and... Like, what? I thought that was going to be short, if anything. God, come on. We have to get out of this with a par. Dude.
Okay.
Like, really?
Bogey.
I find the short putts in this game so difficult. Like, every time it's like a 6-7 footer, there's so much break on them. Like, Jesus, man.
Currently sitting at 2.
I had to aim so far left, and it still wasn't enough there. Cooks McGooks finished 7 under. Damn it. And we're here making bogeys. He finished with 3 straight birdies then. God damn, dude. Okay. If it was going off. 7 mile an hour winds will bring it to 147. It's 10 foot down. That's going to make it, like, go 3 yards further, probably. I'm thinking if we can hit it to 150 to the front. Yeah. I think I can hit this club. I'm not even trolling. Like, legitimately, I can hit this club. You're right.
Looking good.
You're right. Sit, 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 sit. Holy shit, it's too far. Hit the pin! Oh! Still too far. Good lord. Okay. I did hit it fast, but...
Nice
I actually thought that
shot.
Might help us.
Okay.
Apparently, it didn't need to be that hard. 24-footer. When I aim out to the right a good bit, I can't really see the hole from here, so I'm going to switch to this view. That's perfect. Get in. Get in. Get in. Get in. Oh!
This one's 6 feet away.
Man, that was close. That was about as good an effort as we get there. Oh, well, dude, fuck off!
All right, good
I jim. I'm so upset.
As that one drops, that's
there is no need to be upset. I'm so depressed. I literally just, I can't believe this, man. We just had two fucking pathetic bogeys where we missed like two easy putts. Like two, we literally just missed two six, like 3 to 6 footers, man, to take ourselves out of contention. Like that is so depressing. It really is depressing as hell. Oh, I should have been aiming further right there as well. I'm just not thinking now. I've lost all concentration. That's going to go in the heavy stuff. It actually is. Like, just
get out of this. This is
unlegitimately never lucky. That's liking. Wild. I deserved it. I'm such an idiot, dude. Like, I'm so upset with myself.
And back in the fairway. Let's have a nice shot from here. And we've got about 150 yards to the pin from here.
Like, I really should not be this score. The pressing is all hell. And I'll probably miss that putt as well, because we missed the last two from similar distances, actually even shorter.
Okay. 2 under, if you can sink this.
And then that doesn't have enough break. Are you kidding me?
And we're just
like, it actually wrapped back around after the hole.
That'll work. Tapping in for par.
That's the worst 1 under you'll ever see, man. Jesus Christ. Terrible back nine. We were doing so good on the front nine. That was a Turlock ejection if I've ever seen one. I'm doing the second round right now because I'm honestly too upset with myself to leave it like that. That wasn't even the last hole. I thought that was the last hole. I wish it was. That's the first time I've hit a very fast drive in so long. And that genuinely didn't feel any different to any of my other drives. It's going to be light rough at least.
Okay, this shouldn't be too
I'm doing a swing recalibration before I do round two, though. Oh my god, look at that. The wind should actually just offset this. Should be pretty good. It's going to hit this the way it is. Look at that. Wind's going to affect it. Come bring it back. Oh yes. Oh yes, sir. Go on, get up there. It's going to kick right. No. A little bit unlucky, but not bad. We can chip that one in to finish. Come on, let's chip this one in, finish on a high note, and move on to round two with some momentum. Get in! Yes, dude! Yes!
One more look, I think.
Come on, baby, 2 under. Yes, sir! Alright, that was a beauty. Really good chip. Put a tiny bit of loft and it's just perfect. Fell into the front of the hole. My chipping is on point these last few days, I tell you that much. My chipping's been so good. So good. Alright, we're gonna have to settle for a 2 under. Not ideal, honestly, but we can still put ourselves in contention with a really good round. Really good round tomorrow. Or today, because I'm doing it right now, but you know what I'm saying.
Thank you very much for the round. We'll see you next time.
I'm gonna do a swing recalibration, though. With my driver and my irons and see if that makes a difference. Okay, I want to make that change, actually, before we get into this. The change to get a 3-iron instead of a 4-iron, I think, would be the wise choice. Because if I get a 3-iron, I believe it'll go around 190 or so. We don't have a 3-iron with these irons? What do you mean, bro? Why? Why is there no 3-iron? This has a 3-iron. It carries 199. I might go with that then. I might get the HBS Classic 3-iron. Why not? It will be a little bit of a different feel, but that's okay. Because 213, 199 is a much bigger difference, or much less of a difference than 186. So that should make for a more balanced set, I feel like. Even though we have so many different brands of clubs here, it's crazy. I want to eventually have like all TaylorMade Sims or something like that. That could be cool. But right now, I'm just going with whatever works, you know? So let's jump into it. I don't know if I should stick with this driver or not. That's pretty much the same as this lower one. No, the blue one's slightly more forgiveness. Let's try the blue one. Screw it. Let's go. Purchase and equip. We'll give it a bash just for one round and see how it goes. All right, let's go. 12 degree. We'll go with the 10.5. With the wind with us, I feel like... Wait, I thought we changed driver. The Bridgestone driver would be perfect here, damn it. Oh, that sucks. I feel like this will be too much with the wind the way it is today. I don't know. If I hit a big fade with a lot of loft. I don't even know if it's worth trying that.
And this one sliced.
Slow. Yep. It wasn't worth trying. I should have just hit the 3-wood. Would have been probably a lot better, to be honest. Because now we're playing out of the rough. We're going to have to lay up either way, I feel like. Even if we had hit 3-wood, we would have had to lay up.
Deep down in there.
Oh, that's a terrible lie, too. Yikes. Yeah, I feel like laying up is the smart play here. There's no point in going for anything crazy. We'll go with that little short layup there. That's perfect. And hopefully we can... I think we would have had to lay up... Well, maybe not, actually, if I hit the 3-wood, because... We would have been maybe 40 yards back. Well, we would have had to hit 3-wood, probably. And with the bunker the way it is there, it would have made it very difficult anyway. So I'm not tripping too much. We can still get up and down from here for a birdie. And we've made a couple bad decisions on this hole over the first 2 days, though, but we can get away with the birdie here. That was just extraordinarily fast. Oh, we got some backspin on it. That helped a lot.
For the birdie.
I thought that was going to kick on and keep going. We actually have a chance now. Oh, this is an awkward one. It breaks right at the very start, but then it breaks back left a little bit harder at the end, I feel like. That's in. It's got
to
be in.
That appears to be online.
Let's go, baby! Good start. And birdie, yes, on the first. The birdie, and I'm here to play in the second round, baby. I'm here to play. Let's go. 3 under.
And you're under par already here.
Where's Cooks McGooks at? 8 under.
There, and let's,
he's 1 under through 4.
We can get a few more birdies on the scorecard.
If we can finish in the top 5 as it stands, I'd be happy. Nice, like overall, shot, maybe not, but as it stands, I'd be happy. I swear I switched my driver. I pressed purchase and equip. Did I not? I guess not. Perfect drive. I've done the swing recalibration, and that seems here to have helped quite a bit. So I wonder, like, do you have to do it, like, just every now and then? Or every time you start the game, even? Swing recalibration. Like, I'm wondering, does it reset if you turn the game off or something like that? I don't know.
About 175 to the pin.
So I feel like every time after I do it, I'm swinging the club so much better. 6 mile an hour winds. This is going to go on. I think this could be good, this club. Just maybe a tad bit D-loft. No, I hit it slow. Yikes! I knew that was slow the minute I hit it. Go, get it. Big kick left. Right. Left and forward, though. Okay. Straight left. If I didn't hit that slow, it would have been probably perfect, but that's going to come back off the green. All right, we can hit a splash, get up and down.
Shots looking like.
This is a tough hole, man. Really tough hole, actually. 19-yard splash should be perfect here. Really good. Really good. Get in the hole. Oh, ho, ho, ho. All right, tap in par at the second. Tough hole out of the way with a par. We didn't have any bogeys on the front nine yesterday. Let's make it the same today. It's the monster gun. I'm ready. Okay, 5 shots back of the lead.
Third hole coming up.
Let's go.
Take your best shot.
That all you got? Come on, I'll take your best shot. That was fast. A little bit. It's not too fast. It should still stay in the fairway.
Landing on the fairway.
But I knew the second I hit that I kind of pushed it forward a little fast. That's going to go in the rough, isn't it? Like, I swear to God, the fairways are so firm.
Stuff after all.
Like, they're getting huge hops. Like, I would not have thought for a million years that was going to bounce into the rough. I got, oh, that shoots left. Goodness me. I'm going to have to hit the 125, probably. Yeah, I think that should be good, actually. Oh, this is a pitch! Since when? I hate when that happens so much. It worked out okay, but I hate when that happens. It's not okay, really. It's bang average. Back, oh, that shit pisses me off, dude. Like, shot suggestion needs to die!
Your third shot.
Sorry. But seriously, it does. It needs to go. I wish I could turn this shit off. It bugs me so much. Alright, tap in par again.
Hey, I'm liking that one. Nice chip.
It's pretty much a similar start to yesterday. We had one birdie in the first seven holes or something. Then we made another one on the eighth, I think. Alright.
And it looks here like that'll keep you right there at 3 under.
I want to make more birdies today, though. Cooks McGooks is 9 under.
Par three hole for
we
this
got,
one.
This is a tough par three. Fuck me. Jesus, man. That's not easy at all, is it? I feel like this isn't enough. I need to go with the 241. I know that that's too much, and I know there will be too much. Like, it's definitely going to be too much, but it's not a, I don't think the other club's going to be all right with it, you know? It's going to be too far. I know that. Oh, I actually hit a 92% par, but that was slow.
His approach is heading right.
Usually when I hit those partial shots, it's always fast, but that one was slow. Okay. Look how much it rolls on the, on this course. Riviera is legitimately so firm. It's wild. Is it downhill all the way?
Inside rough.
Yeah, it is. I could hit this gap wedge, I think, and it would literally roll out all the way. I think so. Because it's on a downslope too. Go in. Oh my god, it's going to keep going. I should have hit the sand wedge or lob wedge even.
Good luck here. We've got 15 feet.
Thank you for the slice of good luck, sir. Oh, it just broke a little bit more. That's
nice
a bogey.
To get this one. This one's for bogey.
Tough hole, but I shouldn't have bogeyed it. The chip, I should have probably hit a splash there to take that hill out of play. But I thought that the gap wedge would kind of have it roll down and maybe stop out right around the hole, but it just kept going. And it probably would have kept going with any of the chips. I shouldn't have hit a chip there. I should have hit a splash shot. Let's let this fly on the fifth. What did I hit last time? I hit the three wood last time and ended up regretting it. So I'm going to hit driver this time.
Oh, wonderfully struck.
96% power. That's legitimately perfect. It's still too far. Shit. Sit. Sit. But how firm these are, it ain't going to sit. Look how much that kept going. That's not a bad lie, though,
it
looks like.
In the deep stuff currently. Let's get out of here now.
Let's get out of here now. It's on a downslope, so it should go a little bit further. But I don't know if this is going to be enough is the only thing. Probably not, but I'll try my best. Oh, it's too much! Way too much! I didn't think that was going to be enough. It was a 77% lie. Good lord, man.
Here we go. This putt for the birds.
Jesus. Yeah, when it's on a downslope, it makes such a huge difference in this game. That was a really good putt, man. Go in the hole. Go in the hole. Go in the hole. Go in the hole! Oh, what a putt! Can you imagine I made
right,
that?
Finish this hole
that would have been nuts. All right,
okay,
it's a par.
That one went.
Disappointing, really. Disappointing stuff.
Two under for the round.
After a birdie on the first, we kind of petered out. Cooks McGooks is 11 under now. He's going off bad. I could see him winning this tournament if he keeps playing like that. Fair play, buddy. Four iron should run out quite a bit. I'll put some loft on it. So, yeah, I knew I hit that one fast as well. I kind of flicked it forward too much.
Come on, bounce to the right.
Oh, we're going to have to chip that. We're going to have to chip that.
And here's our second shot on the sixth.
Why is it trying to hit? Get me to hit a pitch? Like, fuck off, bro. A pitch. Are you joking? Oh, this is going to be so awkward. Wasn't terrible, but it's a really tough opportunity, and it was just a bad tee shot, man. Yes!
Great putt in there.
That's huge. That was a tough putt. That's huge there. Let's go.
And scorecard says, sticking right there at 2 under after that hole.
2 under, okay. 7 unders in second. 4 unders in third. We're in the top 5. Like, there's only 4 players under par. I wonder how many people have played so far. Probably not that many, but... That's quite impressive that there's only 4 players under par. That was perfect. Absolutely perfect. Scorching drive. Get the kick forward. Don't go right. Oh, it did. Oh, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Everybody stay calm. Everybody stay calm.
Second shot on the seventh.
This should be perfect. This should just legitimately be perfect the way it is. Just the way it is. That's so good. Please be good. Get in the hole. Oh. Just, I was actually thinking maybe I should put a tiny bit of D-loft on it. But
up here, 10 feet from the cup.
I didn't, and that's that. I didn't fucking hit it again. That's literally the pussiest putt you'll ever see.
Use a little bit more power,
I hate myself. I've pussied out of so many short downhill putts where I somehow leave them short. Oh, my God, man.
Two under for the round.
It's so annoying. Like, that was such a good birdie chance. I'm literally not scoring as good as I should be at all. Like, I'm giving myself good opportunities and I'm just not taking advantage of them at all. I'm driving the ball a lot better after that swing recalibration as well. I'm hitting the ball a lot better. We're just not scoring. We're making stupid mistakes in certain parts and we're not holding the putts.
Okay, this is about 125 yards away.
This is perfect. That's so good. All over it. Go. I shouldn't have put loft on it. Oh, I should have. It's perfect. Come on, if I miss that, I'm going to actually just lose my mind.
Coming up.
Yes! Yes! That's a great birdie. We're back in this thing. 3 under. Come on, we need to have a really good back nine to make up for those demons yesterday.
When you bring your score down to 3 under. 3 under.
Cooks McGooks is going off, dude. 12 under. Fair play, man.
This one's a par 4 hole.
I played him yesterday, and like he was good, but I wasn't expecting him to shoot 16 under, man. That's impressive stuff. He just must be on top form right now. Of course, the one place I didn't want to hit fast, it's going to be okay, thankfully. I that's why I decided to aim a little bit right there at the very end. If I didn't, that would have been bunker for sure. 100%. Oh, thank God for that.
20 foot up. Yards to the pin.
This should be perfect. Legitimately perfect. 20 foot up, this should be just ideal. That's so good, dude. Be good!
Be the right club.
Be the right club, as he says. Oh, yes, sir. Sit. What a shot. Are you joking?
Well,
stop.
Done. That's another green.
Oh,
regulation.
Come on.
Okay, sinking.
That's just cruel. It should have stopped. This is a difficult putt, man. We can still make it. Come on.
Well, it's heading towards
it needed more than that. Yikes.
Oh, man.
It's a good effort, but... that was just a difficult putt.
As we head to the next,
some of the short putts on this course are ridiculous. Like, they have so much break. The greens are difficult on Riviera, I tell you that much. I'm struggling with them, personally. Jordy was 4 under at one stage. He's back at level par now.
Okay, teeing up now on the 10th hole.
The 10th hole, okay. We can go for this. It's going to be too far. Like, I got to hit it, like, here. Like, 93% would be perfect. I hit it 93, but I hit it very fast. Damn it. That's the problem with hitting partial shots. As I say time and time again, it's so hard to get the tempo right, and that's going to be a disaster. That's going to be a fucking disaster. That is just... oh, no, man. That is what I would say about that. Oh, fucking no. I literally can't do anything here. I have to just hope that this comes through the bushes. Okay.
Going through some leaves.
Oh, it did. What a shot. Through the bushes. It's going to come back towards the hole a little bit and everything.
All right, this putt.
And if we could make a birdie after that, that would be huge. If I pussy out of this one, I'm going to kill myself. I just want... yes, dude!
Well done.
I thought I did for a second. That's what I got to do, is take the putter back a bit slower with those downhill ones. People have been telling me that in the comments as well, but of course I wasn't really listening, you know? But you guys are right. Cooks McGooks, man. Another birdie. 13 under.
Let's see what we can do here on the 11th.
Okay, par 5 wins with us. This is a green light special here to get something out of this hole.
Now that was a swing.
That's perfect, too. We got absolutely launched up the fairway there, and we should, for real, be making birdie here. At least, at the very worst, a birdie. Like, we probably have, like, two... oh, we still have 250. Holy shit, this is a long hole. Okay, never mind. I thought we were going to have, like, 240. No, I thought we were going to have, like, 200, rather. Okay, we're gonna try hit a little fade, get this one to kick up, because I can still get there. If I hit this good, I hit it fast. It's gonna be okay, but if I didn't hit it fast, it would've been real good, probably. Like it would kick to the right there, you know? Right around the front of the green, but it should come back down a little bit. Or not, it's gonna stay right, green and right there.
For you. Pat yourself on the back.
Oh my goodness me. Are you fucking with me?
To say the least.
You think?
Hopefully we can this.
You think it's a little bit daunting, pal? Okay, I see. I was reading that wrong. Jesus Christ, I'm aiming so far left and I still don't think it's enough. I really don't think this is enough. I hit it dead right, the right power. It's still not enough. Not even close. Not even close. That's going off the green. That is just a ridiculous green here. That is a sick joke, to be honest.
Footer.
Jesus Christ. Come on, turn in. Turn in! Ah! It was always a difficult two-putt, but Jesus, man. I aimed so far left. I was literally nearly aiming off the green, and it still wasn't enough. The greens on Riviera are a sick joke. I don't remember them being this crazy the last time I played, and Cooks McGooks now has a 6-shot lead, 10 shots ahead of us. Wild.
Of a swing there.
Ooh, it's actually good. I thought it was slow. Pretty good. After the swing calibration, I was kind of swinging them a little slower, I think, in the calibration, so the fact that I'm swinging them slower now is actually helping us.
Okay, about 170 yards to the pin.
Like before, I feel like that would have been slow before the calibration. Okay, 6-iron, it's going to kick on a little bit. I feel like I could hit the 7-iron here. It's downhill. 7-iron should kick on a bit. It should be good. Red.
Tee shot could maybe roll into that rough.
Okay.
Well, you're not going to hit every
That was just
green
a wild
today.
Miss.
That's all right. Setting up for our third shot.
I probably could have gone for the 23-yard one there.
On this one. Par save,
the splashes like run out further than you think sometimes. That's why I was a little worried of it.
This one's on a good line.
Yes, sir.
And you're in
yes,
the
sir.
Hole with a nice putt.
All right, good up and down for a par.
And that will
I'd like to finish like 6-7 under. Have a good finish.
And you're 4 under for the
Maybe 20. Even chase that ABZ Hammers guy. He's finished at 8 under. If we could try and tie second, we'd need to birdie 4 of the last 5, actually. That's 4 of the last 6. That's quite unreasonable, I would say, but you never know. You never know. That's a good drive. Gonna be down the left side. Should just catch the fairway. Yes, sir. Oh, no. It's gonna be light rough, if anything. No, it's fine. Okay. Good drive.
Okay, this is about 100.
Definitely playing better second round.
To the pin.
7-iron, 9 foot down, should be like 3, this should even each other out. The 150, would that be enough? I feel like maybe just not. If I hit the iron, not that much. A little bit of deal off on the 8-iron, I feel like would be better. Might be fast, yep. It's gonna be too far.
This one's heading for the green.
A little bit too far, hit it a little fast. If I didn't hit that fast, probably would've been real good, man.
That sure as heck didn't pan out.
Pan out. Didn't pan out. Alright, we're gonna have to have a little bit of a partial chip here. Not that partial, bro.
Okay,
84%. Yikes. Dude, I'm like, I literally fuck up on the easiest shots.
So far so good.
Yes. Yes! That's clutch
nice
as hell. I would have been so upset if we bogeyed that hole from where we were. So upset.
4 under for the event.
That's a clutch up and down there. Well, it was a shit chip, but a clutch putt, I should just say. Alright, we'd literally need a birdie for the last 5 to tie that guy in second now.
Close.
It's not looking likely, but if we can get to 6-7 under, I'd be happy with our round. Be happy with our tournament, even. No, dude, that was actually so slow. Like, that was so slow, and it was red fast. That one is the most confusing one I've ever hit.
Because
I really
approach.
Was, like, about to say, I think that might
okay,
be really slow. That's what I was about to say.
From here.
In my mind, I was saying that. And it was very fast, like right fast. My mind boggles sometimes, man, with this tempo. That was very slow.
Well done out of the bunker.
All right, if we can get away with the par again.
Save par.
No.
Rolled right by. All right, nice 3-footer to deal with. Looking good. And we'll mark down the bogey.
Fucking idiot, dude. That is so stupidly dumb.
And teeing up now in the 15th hole.
We are not scoring well at all in the second round. We're playing so much better than we're scoring. Just legitimately brain dead shots here or there. It's costing us. And missing putts like that, of course, doesn't fucking help, does it? So annoying. It's so annoying. There's no way. There's actually no way that was fast. How am I getting perfect with the driver now and fast with the irons?
Well, you can't hit them all. Okay, here's our third shot.
I'm actually so annoyed right now, if you couldn't tell, guys. Just in case you couldn't tell. In the fucking hole.
Ooh. Nice little chip in for birdie. That was a fine shot.
Okay, we're going to take another look at that. Let's see the replay.
I don't even want to see the replay. I don't care. I don't care. Don't even show it to me. That's how upset I am right now.
4 under par currently. Manager 4.
Oh, such a great chip. 16 under Cooks McGooks finished. Fair fucks to you, Cooks. That is just brilliant play, man. Brilliant play. I must say, fair play. I'm thoroughly impressed by that, pal.
You need a birdie soon here if you want to stay competitive with the top portions of that leaderboard. Let's see what we can do here.
Every iron and wedge shot I'm hitting fast now, by the way. Every single one. Let's fucking go.
Ooh. All right, this next putt for the par.
I thought that was in. Like, legitimately, I literally said, let's fucking go. How close was that, man?
Good so far.
How close was that?
Great putt in there.
Oh, my. That is cruel. We got a par 5 to come here.
Right there.
Come on. Let's finish strong, boys. Two holes remaining. Let's secure our place in third place alone. Rather than being tied for third here. It's a shit drive. Please kick right. Please kick right. Please kick right. Please kick right. Please straighten out. Please straighten out. No, dude!
Ooh.
Be careful.
I didn't deserve it anyway. I didn't deserve it. It was a shit swing and a shit shot. I don't get how that's... Like, I really don't. I'm getting massively confused now. Like, I mean that. I did hit like 4 or 5 slow shots on the swing calibration, and I'm wondering if that affected the irons a lot more, because I'm baffled by the iron, like some of the irons that I'm hitting here that are really fast, and I mean like truly baffled by it. If you couldn't tell from my expressions in my face. I was going to say, if that one's fast, I'm literally logging off and never playing again.
Ooh, we're heading for the green here.
Like, that's going to go in. Oh, I thought that was going to kick on and go in, really.
Found the green there, and that's understating it.
Let's go!
Good
birdie!
Work. Fifth birdie today. Let's have a
Sorry for being so bitchy today, guys. I just feel like I've made some silly mistakes that were very avoidable, which just does trigger me. But overall, like in the tournament, we haven't done too bad. We're 5 under, you know, it could be a lot worse. It could be a lot worse. And we can finish with a birdie here and get to 6 under, all right? That'd be nice. That's going to be okay, I think.
I think I'll take that tee shot. Looks good.
Because this fairway slopes left to right. There you go. It's going to be just fine. It was not a good swing at all. But it's going to be fine. And let's have a look here.
At around
okay, I'm just going to try a couple practice swings.
or so to the pin.
Just to see, like, why I'm hitting it so fast. That was perfect. Okay. Like, that one actually felt faster, though. That was perfect again. Why? I guarantee you this one won't be. Like, I guarantee you the one I actually hit is not going to be perfect. That will trigger me. I'm actually just going to hit the 158 straight up. That was a little fast. Got the fast one out of the way. Yeah, that was. I knew that one was a little bit slow. That's okay. Okay, let's go. That was really slow. Never mind. It's going to be perfect. Go on. Jump up! Okay.
Little play.
I'll take that.
And if you sink this, 67 on the scorecard.
I'll take a 67 if we can get it. That'd be nice.
Going towards that.
Let's go, baby! And let's go! That's a great putt to finish the tournament. 6 under.
Your round is open.
And a 67. 4 under. Not bad.
Under.
We're going to finish in third position at the moment. I don't think we'll finish the society in third position. There'll be a lot more people playing, I'm sure, after this video goes up as well. A lot of you guys will know that it's up. But as you can see, only 5 players under par out of everyone who's played so far. I'll have a look at the leaderboard just to see how many people have played. I'd be interested to see. Because I know a lot of you guys are going to be struggling coming in and playing on my settings. And I do apologize for that. I know there's a lot of people that are upset right now. But I feel like that's the best way to go. Because otherwise, there's going to be a huge advantage for people that are playing with the assists on. And obviously, it's my society. So I'm gonna want to play on my own settings. But I get the frustration. But if you got, like, as I said, I would be willing to set up an alternate event at the same time for people, for beginners, maybe possibly, if that's what people would want. But I think that you guys should just get into this now, learn how to play it, and then it's a much more entertaining game for me, personally, I think, when you get it like that. But there's only 20 people who have played so far. Only 20 people have played the 2 rounds. So there's loads of room there for people to beat my score, of course. I'm only 6 under. Let me know if you beat it. ABZ Hammers and Cooks McDooks. Really good shooting, lads. And good shooting to the baseball guy as well, who's under par. So I swear I saw a 5th player at 2 under there. Where the hell did he go? Where the hell did he go? Maybe he hasn't finished his round yet? Even Darren was 10 over, you know? It's just going to take some getting used to. But I hope you guys all enjoyed the video. I had a blast with it. I really did. And I can't wait to do more societies like that, society events like this in the future. We'll be running all kinds, and we're going to run that match play qualifier soon. So if you're interested in playing in the match play, then make sure to play in that event. That'll probably be after Eastlake. We're going to do Eastlake. And anyway, that's where we're going to end this video. Thank you for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Thank you for all the support. It really does mean the world to me. You guys have legit changed my life here in the last month or so, the last few weeks. So that's been absolutely huge, and I can't wait to continue this journey with you. It's been my pleasure to serve you. Peace out.